So our next question is Rachel from Darfield, and she would like to know where the next rupture of the Alpine Fault is most likely to start. So definitely have our fingers crossed that it doesn't happen anytime soon. But Caroline, could you explain why most often AF8 talks about the Alpine Fault earthquake beginning at the southern end?
Yeah, sure. Yeah, and I guess the first thing to say is that we don't know exactly when the Alpine Fault, where the Alpine Fault epicenter will be. You might have seen the simulations that are on YouTube with that epicenter showing down in the Milford Sound kind of area and the seismic energy pushing up towards the northeast. So just to give you a bit of context around that, when we started planning the AF8 scenario, we began with three different ones. The first one with the epicenter around Milford, the second up in the northern part of the Alpine Fault, which resulted in more of the seismic energy pushing down towards the southwest, and the third scenario beginning on the central part of the Alpine Fault around the glaciers and the seismic energy going out in two different directions. We wanted to move forward with one scenario for the purposes of planning for AF8. And so the consensus amongst the science team was that the south to north rupture, in other words, that Milford Sound epicenter was the most scientifically credible, as well as the fact that it sort of presented the greatest challenge to civil defence and those partner agencies in terms of planning for a future event. And the reason for that is because that southern epicenter pushes the energy up to the northeast, where most of the population of the South Island lives, where the greatest sort of proportion of our highway network would be affected. So this would sort of present almost sort of a worst case Alpine Fault scenario. And so that's why we went with the south to north scenario for this planning, the purposes of this planning. Yeah, Rob, you might want to add to that in terms of the science and the evidence around that.
Oh, I guess that's a pretty good answer. I'd say, in very simple terms, like I was saying before, the southern part of the Alpine Fault is quite simple. It's a simple plate boundary, and as it progresses to the northeast there, it merges into that Marlborough Fault system. And so the idea was that perhaps the epicenter would be in the southwest and progress from something simple towards something more complicated, where the earthquake might be arrested in that area.
Great, thank you both for that.